I gotta ask you. We're at a hip hop karaoke event. This is Fatlip. Should there be words on a screen for hip hop karaoke?
To have lyrics on a screen.
Because there's, you know what? There's different degrees of hip hop fans. Some fans know one song of one artist. Some fans know the entire album word for word. Some fans only know the chorus. So I think it's, yeah, it should be optional. I don't think you should judge the contestant based on that. I think the fact that they get up there and, you know, they want to perform the song, I think it's okay.
Played a record the other day, Nirvana, Nevermind, 20 years since 2011. It's been 17 years since you and Pharcyde did your thing.
Are you nostalgic?
I'm very nostalgic. That's a very special, magical, like wonderful, like literally. I wonder how that shit happened. Like it's truly a wonderful. moment, truly a wonderful time. All of that whole era, not even just what was going on with myself and the group, but just the whole era in general. You know what I mean?
Early '90s, mid '90s for hip hop was a great time.
Early '90s, I'm pretty nostalgic when it comes to that.
So, are you nostalgic in other ways?
Not really.
But as far as Pharcyde goes, you are nostalgic.
Yeah,
that shit was fucking off the wall.
Yeah, I mean it's. I mean, you know, like you say, after 20 years, it's like. You know, as time goes by, you realize more and more what it's meant, what it meant to people that were fucking 5 years old at the time, but you didn't even know. I didn't even know there was 5 year olds in 90. You know what I mean? Like now that like those same kids are at the show, it's pretty good.
One of my favorite songs off the band is She Said. I think it was because everyone was doing their thing. De La Soul was doing their thing. Roots were doing their thing. But you guys had a soulful thing to your vibe as well.
Yeah.
Was there any, you know, church or what was like the
a lot of church. Yeah. For me, yeah. A lot of church. Like serious church. Like moms directing the choir, having to turn the piano, having to turn the music for the piano player. When she nods her head type church, and drum church, singing church, and but not only church, it was, I always tell this story, Reggie Andrews is a guy who was basically our mentor, and he was the guy where it was his studio where we recorded, he saw in us, something that he hadn't seen since the 60s, which was, you know, trying to be like conscious,
but also like super just like, hey, we gotta find some weed tonight, or you know,
yeah,
just down to earth.
Yeah. Well, he didn't really smoke weed, but he got it. He understood it. He was past that because he was at the time he was 40, 44 or something like that. But he definitely recognized. You know, because I guess it's a lineage that goes on, because I see it today. There's a lot of kids out right now, like in the 90s, you know, that got that 90s flavor that I can definitely point to and recognize. And it's like, without even trying, those dudes are feeling it just how we was feeling it, you know what I mean? Without even thinking about it, they don't even know. So it's something, I don't know what it is.
You mentioned earlier that you are nostalgic or proud about what happened with Pharcyde. Do you feel that it also can, like, you know, people always see Fatlip as part of Pharcyde?
Yeah. Yeah.
Could it also, like, play against you, though?
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, I did that.
Yeah, I did it. Like, I mean, it can play against it if I allow it to by not progressing and doing anything different, like wearing the Pharcyde Letterman jacket for the rest of my life. But I don't do that. I never did that. We rocking it right now because it's the 20-year anniversary, you know what I mean? So we're going to celebrate that. But, I didn't, like, up until 92, until now, I wasn't, like, rocking the Pharcyde Letterman jacket. Not really, you know what I mean? I did my own shit, you know, for better for worse. No pun intended. It's been great. I'm still alive. You know what I'm saying? I'm making some money. You know what I mean? And I'm still alive. You know what I'm saying? I'm still, like, sane. And I've actually grown as an artist. I've actually grown as, like, just an overall, whatever, musician. My ears, like, more focused than it was even when I was younger. You know what I mean? I've grown. I never stopped. You know, I love music. Yo, this is Fatlip. Chilling, you know what I'm saying? London calling. Let's do it, let's do it.